When I first met him and went to Detroit to visit him, he picked me up in his Navigator, blasting Mecca and the Soul Brothers. And as I'm walking out the airport, and I'm like, wow, and I'm getting my beat tapes ready, and I'm like, yo. So I get in the car, and we just start kicking it, pound each other up, hug, and I start whipping out these beat tapes, popping them in, and he's like, you know, bugging and getting inspired, and I'm getting inspired. And once we get to his house, we just start playing around with music. And you know, I ended up doing the song called Once Upon a Time, which was on the first Slum Village album, but it was a different version. And then he flipped it on a remix to show off his talent in front of Pete Rock. So I was really blown away, and it was just such a great relationship. And I spoke to his mother, and she calmly whispered, J. Dilla always wanted to be like you. And I was like, wow, that's amazing. I mean, I felt like he's done his homework and some. So he's taken it a couple of steps higher than I did. Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, I mean, no. I'm telling you, I know skill when I hear it, you know, and he definitely had it. And it was just fun to be around him. He's such a humble individual, and he's such a nice person. And you find that in this world. You don't find too many people like that.